Hi guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be doing, basically we're going to be painting the grill, fog surrounds, and possibly the rear diffuser, but we'll see how that goes. Probably just the front for now. So I bought this from Halfrauds. This is £3. It's a very fine to fine, basically scotch pad, pretty much. So you've got the fine side, which is that side. Oh, sorry, the very fine side, which is that side. The fine side, this side. Then we've got this. This is an all-surface paint. Got it from B&Q. It was the one that everyone recommended that I do. Basically, it goes on anything. And apparently, you don't need primer to do it. So we'll see how that goes. I'm not looking to get rid of the texture on the grills and the fog surrounds. So yeah, not looking to get rid of the texture or anything. Just literally making to look at gloss black. So that's that. And then from Halfrauds, I just got some Bodyshop Lacquer because obviously I wanted the kind of the best quality lacquer I could get because it is on the front of the car. It is going to get hit by a bunch of stones. I need it to last as long as possible. So I got that. So that was about 10 quid. That was about 15 quid. And then, like I said, about £3 for that. I also bought some panel wipes from Halfrauds. They were like £1.50. Basically, they're like lint-free wipes. So once you've sanded and stuff, you can use those wipes to get all the extra dust off and stuff. So the process will be basically, I'm going to just use the very fine side just to kind of get, I think they call it a key into it. So you just basically, you sand it enough so it goes slightly dull. And then that way this paint will stick onto it. You can primer it first if you want to. I just don't think it's worth the time because you're going to end up with pretty much the same results, I think. Obviously, only time will tell. So yeah, sand it first. Just sand up every little bit. You've got one side that's fine, like I said before. One side that's very fine, including the sides here. So you can use the sides there to get in there. Then spray this. Plan is 2 to 3 coats on every single bit, depending on how much paint I have left. So 2 to 3 coats of this, and then the lacquer, once again, 2 to 3 coats probably of this. It does suggest that you do, you might be able to see that, basically to do kind of small amounts, I say small amounts, like light coatings of it every 20 to 30 minutes, and it will make it last a lot longer. So I'll just keep doing that for a while, and that will make it extra glossy as well. I kind of bought it so it makes it even more glossy. High gloss, as you can see. All right, so we'll get on with that and I'll let you guys know how it goes.
Hi guys, so the easiest way to remove the fog light is to put your finger in here. Basically, you just pull there, pull it out, and then you pull this bit off. Okay, so next step's super simple. So I got the fog surround off. I've literally got this from Halfrauds. It was like 3 quid. Basically, it's a very fine scouring pad. So you got fine and then very fine on the back. But literally all we're going to do is just use the very fine side and just go up and down on it until it kind of comes out like a slightly cloudy colour. Okay, so the bottom one's now been slightly prepared, so you can hopefully see the difference. Hopefully you can see that. And obviously it's not hard. It's quite hard to see because obviously I'm literally using the fine side of this. Once again, just make sure you get, you know, in between that gap, around there, inside, everywhere like that. And that will kind of allow the paint to adhere a little bit better. So as you guys can see, I've already started painting this one. But I'll run you through the process of on the fog lights, but this is really simple to get off. All you literally do is just pull it. So just get your fingers behind and pull. I've slightly sanded it down, and then basically just put my first coat of black gloss on it. I didn't bother with primer because obviously it's just plastic. Okay, so I'm onto my second coat now. As you can see, I'm quite happy with how it's turning out. Obviously there's always going to be bits because of the stone chips and stuff, but from a distance I think it looks good. Okay, so we're back. We've now done 3 coats, about half an hour drying time between each one. So after half an hour, just put another coat on, but you can see it's coming out well. And that's the stuff that I've used.
You can pick this up from B&Q. Yeah, I'm happy with it. Hi guys, so we're back. It's now the evening of the second day. It's lacquer time. That's what we're doing next. So first thing I'm going to do is use these. I found my wipes. These are paint preparation wipes, but it can be used. It says it here somewhere. It can be used on everything, and then I'm sure it says it somewhere. There we go. Use at various stages of the paint process. So obviously they're fully painted now. I'm now going to use these, or one of these, to go over it just before I lacquer everything, just to get any kind of dust that's inside my house, get any of that off, and then go from there. So I'm just going to get a quick pause, start to wipe it down, and I'll show you guys the results. Okay, so I've got one out. I'm literally just going to gently rub over it just to get rid of kind of any dust. I'm not pressing obviously too hard because it is a freshly painted surface and it's only had 24 hours to dry. But just to get rid of any big bits. So other than that, I'm now going to do that one and that one, and then we're all good. You can see it leaves a little bit of water behind. I say water, like alcohol behind, but that will soon dry very, very quickly. Okay, so next step, I'm literally just shaking the can as much as I possibly can for the next kind of minute. I'm going to spray from one side, leave for 20 minutes, then spray from another side, leave for 20 minutes, and then kind of go over the whole thing in multiple directions one last time. So I'm going to do three coats, each with about 20 to 30 minutes gap in between. And then I'm going to put them in my on my car after about half an hour of drying time, I think. Obviously, as long as they dry, but we'll see how we get on after that. Okay, so we're going to have a go at this now. I've been shaking the can for 2 minutes. And literally, we're going to start over here. I'm going to spray across it and then stop here, but then carry on spraying. So I'm literally just going to go backwards and forwards, but I'm going to go all the way past it. The reason you do that is because a lot of people spray can. They spray like that, like that, like that, and you don't actually know where you're hitting. So just do one continuous spray, start off of it. If you start like here-ish, and then just go over it, and then stop here-ish. And the reason why you stop here-ish is you don't want to stop on the end of it, because then you're just covering this with tons, and this with a little bit, because you're just passing it. So literally just spray, so get it started first, and then just all the way across, like that. So we'll do the next one now. So once again, just start on the side, all the way along, and then back, and then back. Last one, once again, start on the edge and just from the bottom all the way up, and that's it. There's one coat of lacquer on. Now we're just gonna leave that to dry. In about 20 minutes time, we'll put another one on. Okay, so 20 minutes later, we're back. You can physically feel the lacquer layer. It now starting to feel like glass rather than plastic. Actually quite a shock when you guys come to doing this yourself, just how much the lacquer actually changes the texture of the actual fog or the plastics. I should just call them plastics, shouldn't I? Anyway, on to the second one. So rather than spraying from this direction this time, we're going to come round and spray from this way. So always change up obviously the direction that you're spraying from, just so you get an even coat everywhere. So once again, shake the bottle, gonna shake this for about a minute, and then I'll be back and we'll do the second layer. Okay, so we're back, just popping the top. Okay, so second coat, start off seat for somewhere else and then literally just straight across. One done. Two done. I'm sure there's better methods of doing this, and I would highly recommend not doing it indoors like I am, because let's just say you get very, very, very high on this stuff. So unless you want to be super, super high, don't do it indoors, and it's actually starting to affect me now. So I will leave you guys there. That's the second coating done. You can already see here how shiny it's becoming with the lacquer on top. We'll probably do one more coat after this, which will kind of be from like this angle all the way along. And then we may call it a day and install them from there. Anyway, I'm going to go outside for a bit because my house is now gassed, basically. Okay, so here we are, next morning. It's third day now. We're just going to literally put it back into here so you can see it's got little clips. You just line this up and push, and it will go on. I'm going to do it two-handed just so I don't break it, but just literally push all the way along. That sounds super easy. You just push, literally, one at a time, and it all goes in, but you just really, really push it. You'll hear a click on, especially on the ends, and I've heard a click about this one, but the rest haven't clicked. Okay, so the fog light's also super, super simple to do. You've got these tabs, and you've got those holes. What I done first, we'll bind this one up. Push that in, you hear a click, and then just work around pushing all those in. So there you go guys, that finishes my painting and installation of the gloss black mirrors, but hopefully you can see the improvement that I've got from that. Anyway guys, I'll see you next time. Remember to like, favourite and subscribe, and I'll see you in future videos.